Details tag is one of the most useful features of HTML5. You can create an interactive toggle widget without using JavaScript at all. But do you know, with the right CSS hack, it can create lots of cool examples like these. So in this episode, we'll show you how to make it from scratch in just a few minutes. Ready? Let's check it out. Here's what details tag looks like without any CSS. There is a summary tag, which is the headline, and then you can click at it to expand the details. I know it looks ugly, but trust me, you're gonna love it at the end of this video. So let's start with our basic example first. First, I'm going to add a headline and a wrapper div to wrap all the details tags. Then inside the details, I will create a summary tag. Then next to it, I will create a paragraph for the content. Let's duplicate it to create 4 items. Now let's add some CSS styles. First, I will set the wrapper width and margin 0 auto to center it. Then for the summary tag, I will set the font size, weight, and color. Then set margin, padding, and small border radius. Also set the text align to left. Looks good. Now let's add the animation. When the details tag is clicked, the open attribute will be added. So we'll use CSS selector to check the open state. We'll increase the margin bottom when the tag is opened. Then add a half second transition to create the animation. Also add cursor pointer to change the cursor to hand icon. Looks good, but our hack is not going to stop here. Here's our next example we are going to work on. I got an inspiration from this code pen challenge, but I rewrite some CSS to use flex layout instead of float, since it's easier to understand. So first, I'm going to add a wrapper to wrap each of the details tag. Then for the CSS, I will set the main wrapper width to half of the viewport. Then for the detail wrapper, set width to 100%. Add some margin bottom and set display to flex. For the details tag itself, we'll set the width to 50%. And here's what it looks like so far. Then we'll use nChild selector to set justify content to right for even details tags. Then do the opposite for the odd one. Next, we will work on the center line. We will use before pseudo element. Then set the width to 3 pixels and gray background to create the line. Next, we will set the position to absolute and set both top and bottom to 0 to expand the line. Then set left to 50% to place it at the center. Also, we'll need to add position relative to the wrapper to set the reference point for the position absolute of the child element. Next, we'll work on the icon. I will use Font Awesome Free Font. We'll include it to our project using CSS file from CDN. You can find more information about Font Awesome on their website. Then I will use After Pseudo Element to add the icon. First, set the font family and content to the checkmark character Unicode. Then set the font size, color, width, and height. Then we'll set position to absolute and 50% left to center it. Also set the background to white and increase z-index to bring the icon on the top of the line. And finally set the margin and border radius. And that's all for this HTML5 CSS hack episode. If you like this tutorial, don't forget to subscribe our channel to stay tuned for the update. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Bye.